A very good evening to one and all present here. I'm Dr. Priya, consultant radiologist from MGM Healthcare. I'm here to give a brief talk on basics in breast images. As all of you are aware, the incidence of breast cancer is steadily on the rise, and especially in Indian scenario, it is very much worrying because more of young females are being diagnosed with breast cancer. So it is all the more important that we pick up breast cancers at a very early stage so that the prognosis is good. So in imaging, to make an early diagnosis of breast cancer, we have a gamut of modalities, namely the mammogram, sonomammogram or the ultrasound breast, and the MR mammogram. So, the general practitioner is the first line doctor who comes in contact with majority of the patients presenting with breast symptoms. So it is very essential that they are aware of the modalities available and which modality to ask for which patient and how often the imaging has to be repeated. So today I will be focusing on more on these aspects rather than the proper imaging, when to ask for which modality. So as all of you know, X-ray mammogram basically modification of the radiograph. Basically we take two views, an MLO view, which is a medio-lateral oblique view, and a craniocaudal view. Two views are taken. And then we have the ultrasound. Now we will see a few slides about the basic imaging modalities, then we will go to the clinical scenarios. Ultrasound, as all of you know, it is the modality for imaging young patients, because the breast parenchyma is very dense in young patients and a mammogram may not give much information. Small lesions may go undetected, so for them the ideal modality of investigation is the ultrasound. Also, in addition, in pregnant patients, in lactating patients, any complaints are there, then we go ahead with first an ultrasound. And again, even if you detect any abnormality in an X-ray mammogram, for further characterization of the lesion, we need an ultrasound. Both a cyst and a solid lesion may look alike on an X-ray mammogram. Whereas if you do an ultrasound, you may get the answer. And again, for interventions, this ultrasound-guided biopsies, FNACs, all these are like important roles of ultrasound. Rather than doing under X-ray guidance, it is very easy when it is done under ultrasound guidance, more comfortable for the patient and also less of no radiation when compared to X-ray mammogram. Next, little bit regarding the indications for MRI. So it is a very important screening tool for high risk patients. For the general population, an X-ray mammogram and an ultrasound would suffice, whereas in very high risk patients, an MR mammogram is very essential. And again, for a preoperative staging for newly diagnosed cancers, especially when the surgeon is thinking of conserving the breast, going for a breast conservation surgery, then we have to definitely rule out any multifocal or multicentric breast cancers. For that, MRI plays a very important role. Then to evaluate the effect of neoadjuvant chemotherapy, whether the tumor is responding or not. For the evaluation of women with breast implants, for evaluating occult primary breast carcinomas, suspected local recurrence, and as a problem-solving tool, where the findings in mammogram and ultrasound are not conclusive, still we are not sure whether it is a benign or a malignant lesion, the patient doesn't want to go for a biopsy, then again MR mammogram helps. Next we come regarding the screening mammograms. Basically two types of mammogram we do. One is in the screening setup, another is the diagnostic setup. A screening setup is wherein the patient doesn't have any complaints, but to detect early, pick up early breast cancers in the general population, we do a baseline mammogram, including two views, the MLO view and the CC view, that is a screening mammogram. Next is a diagnostic mammogram, wherein the patient comes to the doctor with a complaint, either a lump, nipple discharge, itchy, any complaint, and then we go ahead with a mammogram. This diagnostic mammogram sometimes may need additional views, like a spot magnification or a compression view, and usually an ultrasound is also done. So first we'll see a few slides regarding the screening mammogram. All over the world, each country has its own guidelines. Some countries it is done every 2 years, some places 3 years, and at the age at which we begin to do is also different across the globe. So in our country we have this BSI, that is Breast Imaging Society of India, and it recommends to start screening mammogram at the age of 40 years. Then after that, every year opportunistic screening annual mammogram can be done up to the age of 70 years. After 70 years, it's up to the patient's comorbidity, general condition, and the clinician's decision to go ahead for a screening mammogram. First, what we saw is regards to the general population. Then we have this high-risk group, wherein the patient has some germline mutations like BRCA1, BRCA2, and all the family members have BRCA1, BRCA2 mutations, very strong family history of cancer. So all these puts the patient under a high-risk category. For these patients, routine mammogram screening is not sufficient. Both an MRI and an X-ray mammogram is needed for screening these patients. And the age also we begin at 30 years, not at 40 years. So a little bit earlier we start screening these patients so that we do not miss any cancer. So we've seen when to do a start a screening mammogram up to what age. Now we'll go to the diagnostic setup. We'll see according to each of the symptoms. The most common symptom which the patient presents to us is a breast lump, and it is also the most common presenting complaint of a breast cancer. So when the patient presents to you, a triple assessment is very essential, which includes a detailed clinical breast examination and imaging, and then a pathological test which can either be an FNAC or a biopsy. So imaging modality, what do we advise? If the patient is less than 30 years, an ultrasound. More than 30 years, an X-ray mammogram with an ultrasound. This is the guideline. And the next symptom is a mastalgia. The most common causes, as you know, hormonal variations, trauma, infection, and so on. So for any symptom, as told earlier, a triple assessment is done. Detailed clinical examination is done. So if the pain is bilateral and it is typically cyclical, then no, and the clinical examination is normal, we are not palpating any lump, then no imaging is needed at all. In case the pain is very localized or you are seeing some vague lump or the patient is has a high risk for developing CA, then you go ahead with the imaging. So here again the same thing. If the patient is less than 30 years, we ask an ultrasound. More than 30 years, X-ray with ultrasound. If the pain is very severe, then we can avoid a mammogram because most of the patients find it uncomfortable when they have a mastalgia. Tolerable, then better to do. If it is very acute, painful condition, then better to go for an ultrasound. Next, in case of acute mastitis, again it is a clinical diagnosis and the patient is managed conservatively with antibiotics. In case the patient is not responding or the condition is worsening, then we go ahead for an imaging. Here definitely mammogram it will be difficult to perform and ultrasound is recommended. Here again, if the abscess is very much liquefied, ultrasound can help us in draining the abscess collection. And in case of non-lactational mastitis, definitely a follow-up mammogram should be done after the patient recovers to see if there is any residual or this non-resolved lesion which has to be biopsied. Next, regards to the nipple discharge, this caused due to either physiological, hormonal disorders, papilloma, ectasia or ducts. And again, first clinical breast examination. We should see whether the discharge is unilateral or bilateral. If it is bilateral, some yellowish clear discharge which is not spontaneous and there is no lump detected on examination, then it doesn't need any further imaging. Maybe few hormonal tests would suffice. In case if it is unilateral, very spontaneous blood stained or serous, any of the suspicious features are there or there is an associated lump or the patient is an elderly, then definitely it is worthwhile doing an imaging. Here again, ultrasound is done up less than 30 years of age. More than 30 years, mammogram with ultrasound. For such cases, we usually do first mammogram followed by ultrasound. In case of nipple discharge, we advise an ultrasound first followed by mammogram because the contents of the dilated duct can be evaluated. If we do a mammogram first, then it is expressed and we can't see the contents. So if there is suspicious discharge and no abnormality is found in mammogram and ultrasound, then we can ask for an MRI. Then in the patients who complain of discharging skin conditions, then again the causes could be any chronic infection or fungating cancers or those causes. Again, after a detailed history and breast examination, ultrasound is done. If it is an eczematous, very itchy skin, painful skin, it is difficult to do a mammogram. And depending upon the ultrasound findings, further management is. Next, so the pain, in case the patient is already a known CA, mastectomy is done, and how do we follow up the patient? We recommend an annual physical examination and an X-ray mammogram, and always the patient should be educated to bring the previous mammogram. The current mammogram can be normal, but always the comparison with the previous mammogram is necessary. And if you find any lesion suspicious, and even if it is not classically benign, it has to be further evaluated. Just a slide on the role of imaging, not only in diagnosis, also in therapeutic interventions like fine needle aspiration, biopsy, any cyst aspiration, many tense cysts which will relieve the patient's symptoms, for core biopsy, preoperative localization. If the lesion is very small and not palpable, the surgeon may not find the lesion on palpation. Then we do a wire localization so that he can go along the wire and operate the lesion. So these are the additional roles of imaging. Just a few basic few slides on basic imaging features. So in a mammogram, we look for certain primary signs and secondary signs. Primary signs being mass, asymmetry, calcification, and the secondary sign architectural distortion, ductectasia, nipple retraction, and skin thickening. So we always localize the lesion in a mammogram with respect to the quadrants. That's why we take two views, whether it, which quadrant we can localize with the help of both the views. And most of the times an ultrasound is also done. Here we localize the lesion with respect to clock position. So for example, in the first, in the right breast, it is a lesion in the 12 o'clock position. And we also divide the breast into three circles arbitrarily. So circle 2, 12 o'clock position. Sometimes we also mention the distance from nipple and depth from the skin, in which plane it is. Whether it is subcutaneous fat, parenchymal or deep mammary fat, all those can be helpful. So this is just an example of a highly suspicious lesion. Its appearance on mammogram, so you can see the ill-defined stipulated margins, and in the ultrasound we are able to see a taller than wider. That feature is very suspicious. Taller than wider hypoechoic lesion in the ultrasound in the next image. So this is a Birax 5 lesion. So what is Birax? We come to the data. This is a suspicious microcalcification, which is pleomorphic and branching type. Now all these will be picked up only on an X-ray mammogram. That is why we insist on an X-ray mammogram for an elderly patient. So what is BIRADS? It is Breast Imaging Reporting and Data System. It is developed by a group of surgeons, pathologists and radiologists to establish uniformity in reporting in breast pathologies. And also it is more comfortable to convey to the physician how benign or how malignant the lesion appears. So we have six categories. Zero is incomplete. Suppose we are in a screening setup, we are seeing a very dense breast mammogram. We cannot comment anything upon on the from the mammogram. We need an ultrasound to say it is normal. In that case, it is under zero category. One is negative. There is, it is normal breast. Two is benign, like involuting fibroadenomas, all those comes under two. Three is probably benign, four is suspicious, five is highly suspicious, and six is a already biopsy proven case of malignancy. They would have come to us to look at for the extent and multifocality and axillary nodes. Four again, we have a subdivision, 4A, 4B and 4C, which is low, intermediate and high risk for malignancy. So in our final mammogram report, we include all these things. First is the breast density, whether it is a dense breast or a fatty breast, heterogeneous, dense or extremely dense. Then if at all any mass or calcifications are there, we may comment on that. And always imaging of the breast is incomplete without evaluation of the axilla. If at all any prominent nodes are there, whether you think it is reactive or suspicious, all these should be mentioned in the report. And finally, considering all the features, mass, calcification, we give assign a BIRADS category. Then after that, definitely we should comment whether any follow-up is needed, if needed with ultrasound or X-ray or what, after how many months, and if at all any intervention is needed, whether it is an ultrasound guided biopsy or FNAC or stereotactic guided biopsy, all those have to be mentioned. Thank you.